Hello everyone, in this tutorial we're going to be taking a look at behaviours in Wade. Now behaviours are quite an in-depth topic, but we are going to demonstrate that with some basic functionality first. So let's just click here to add a new scene object, and we get our procedural square sprite as we normally do. We're going to go to functions, and we are going to go to onMouseDown. Now in here, we're going to select some random x and y coordinates and then move the square to those. So it's just some basic functionality so I can demonstrate what behaviors are useful for. So var x equals bracket math, oops, that's meant to be capital, math.random minus 0.5 times by 1000. Now that will give us a number between positive 500 and minus 500 for our x coordinate. And we're just going to copy and paste that for our y coordinate. Then of course we just need this dot move to x, y, and a speed of about, we'll try 200. So now we've got our function. When we run the program and click on the square, it should just move in a random direction. So let's run, click the square, and indeed it moves straight off the top of the screen. But that's okay, that's what it's meant to do. So let's just run that again, see if it moves a different direction. If you keep clicking it, it'll keep moving different directions. So we've got some functionality. So we have a moving square, but what if you want a moving triangle? Well, we could change the sprite to a triangle or a star or anything we want really. But what if we wanted to apply this to another object? We'd have to copy and paste the code, and that's not ideal, because if you've got a more complex system, and you have to change the code in one place, you're going to end up having to change it in all the different places that you've copy and pasted it, which is really not ideal, and it also results in your program being a lot larger and more complex than it needs to be. So to solve this, we have a behavior system. Now to create a new behavior, we're going to right click down here, new file, and we're going to call it randommovement.js. So we're just creating a little script. If we double click on it, we should get the code editor. So let's again call it random movement equals function and in brackets there. So the behavior we want is this on mouse down. We want this to happen still, but we don't want the code to be part of the object itself. We want it to be part of the behavior. So we still need a on mouse down function. So this dot on mouse down equals function, and we're just gonna copy and paste the code up here. Actually, cut and paste, I should say. So let's just neaten this up a bit. Now, one change we do need to make is instead of having this dot move to, we need to write this dot owner, because this is now referring to the behavior, not the parent object. So this dot owner refers to the parent object, which has the move to function. So if we run this again, we'll find nothing happens, because of course we've cut and pasted the code from on mouse down, but we've not actually added our behavior yet. So when you create a new script, you need to deselect everything, look at the scene properties. We have this scripts tab here, and here we can just write random movement, and it comes up with the prediction, and we click add. So now this script has been added to our scene. We can add it to any object we want. So if we just click on our square again, we can click on behaviors, and here we have an add behavior option. Now if we had more than one behavior in this drop down list, it would show up, but as it is, we only have the one, random movement. So we select that and click on plus. So now our scene object, the square, has the behavior random movement. So if we run our program once again and click on the square, it moves once again because it has the movement behavior. Well, and it goes off the screen. And before we go any further, I'm just going to quickly rename this scene object to square, because I want to demonstrate the reusability of this. Behaviors in Wade are modeled after the entity component system. For those of you who know what that is, it's basically a very nice way of decoupling things, and it makes a lot more of your code reusable. You can just add, so if we were, well, we'll show you. If you want another scene object, which we'll have, we'll call this one star, and I'll just move it off to the left a bit. And we will also change it to a procedural star sprite. There we go. So this is demonstrating the reusability. Instead of having to rewrite this whole thing again, all we have to do is go to our behaviors once again, add the random movement behavior, click play, and now if we click on the star, it also has this ability. So not only does this help the reusability, it just makes it easier. Well, copying and pasting code is usually bad. In most cases, you want to try and avoid it because you can end up with duplicated code all over the place, all of it doing slightly similar but slightly different things, and it becomes very messy and hard to manage. So the behaviors in Wade is the solution to this. Now, of course, we can have a slightly more complicated behavior if we wish, but before we do that, I'm actually going to demonstrate this variable here is hard-coded, which is far from ideal. So what we can do is create a public member variable here of this behavior, this.speed equals 200. 200 will be the default, so all we do is copy and paste that into here and save it. And now we're just going to remove the behavior from everything. Okay, in fact, we'll remove it from both of them because I'm going to do something magical in a minute. I'm just going to quickly re-add it only to the star just to show you the difference. So now when I add the random movement behavior, we have this speed here appear in the editor. The editor will show you all the public members of the behavior. So that's really, really useful. So if we want to change the speed to make it slower, we'll just put that at 50. If I click on it, it moves a lot slower. Of course, the square doesn't do anything because I removed the behavior from it. Now, of course, you can have more than one behavior per object if you want, but let me just demonstrate a different behavior. We're going to add another one just to really get it in our heads how this works. So let's just right click here, new file, and we're going to call this behavior spin.js. So we double click here. Just as before, we create the behavior spin function. Now, I should say you don't have to do this just for on mouse down. You can do it for a lot of other events if you want, but we're going to keep it simple for now. So this dot on mouse down equals function. So in here, we are going to do this dot owner. Remember the owner for the parent object, not the behavior. Because obviously the behavior itself doesn't have this property, it's just getting it from the parent. So this dot owner set angular velocity. And we'll try 0.2. Actually, let's have our speed variable again, because that makes more sense. This dot speed equals hard-coded variables are never good. So this speed 0.2. We'll put it in there and we'll just add the colon there that I've missed off. Okay, so I'm going to demonstrate this now. I'll just quickly go to my square though and add the random movement behavior. But for the start, we're going to make it spin. So first we need to add the behavior to Wade because it doesn't know about it yet. So we deselect everything, scene properties, scripts, spin.js, and again it finds it and we click add. So now Wade knows about two behaviors. So if I go to our star, it has the random movement behavior, but it can also have the spin behavior if we wish. So if we toggle down to spin and click add, and there we go, spin also has a speed. So let's just click run and click on our star. Now that's spinning a bit slowly and it's moving slowly still. So we're gonna go into random movement, put the speed up to 150. And in spin, we'll increase the angular velocity to 0.75. We'll try. That should be good. And if we play now, the star's spinning faster. I still think it could be quite a bit faster, actually. Let's go all the way up to 1.5 spin. There we go. And the star keeps spinning because there's nothing to tell it to stop. But it moved and then it spins, moves and spins. And the square just moves. We could set the square to spin as well if we want. We can just set it to have one. So we have the square with its random movement behavior. We have the start with its random movement and spin behavior. And just for comparison, let's quickly add a circle, which I'll just drag over here. Sprites, procedural, circle. Now, interestingly, we could add the spin behavior to this, but we wouldn't be able to see it because if a circle spins, it's perfectly symmetrical. You would not be able to tell unless you had an image that was in a circular shape. So again, let's just click run. Got our moving square. Got the spinning star and our circle. So that's behaviors. Very easy to reuse. It makes your code much neater if you can make use of them. And also, they're very easy to share. So if you've got a friend who's coding something and he wants help, say maybe a health bar, for example, I believe there's currently one actually in the share and fork section of Wade, you can just go there and say, well, I can just use his health bar and just add it as a behavior to my dragon object or whatever it happens to be in your game.